taking a closer look at charter schools. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Pennsylvania State Representative James Roebuck. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
You have a recent report that you've put out related to charter schools and cyber charters. What was the purpose of this report? And then we'll get into some of the outcomes.
Sure. The legislature has been considering the status of charter schools, legislation that creates charter schools, and reviewing that legislation. A number of bills have been offered. What I tried to do in part was to pull together all the legislation, offer comparisons, and offer my own legislative approach, but also look at the record of charter schools and things that might be done to improve them and enhance their those schools.
And when we get into the details of this report, what did you find in terms of how charter schools are doing?
I think charter schools, I would begin by saying I do support the concept of charter schools. I think some of them are doing very well. Some of them are not doing well. And I think the problem has been that charter schools, which were designed to be innovative, they were supposed to be set new directions to try new things, offer new options in terms of the delivery of educational services to children, have failed in some ways to do that. And in fact, the original charter school bill calls upon them to give regular reports on those innovations. That hasn't happened. So we're looking at ways to get them back to what they're supposed to do and make them indeed the cutting edge for educational change.
And that's one component, the idea of cutting edge education, innovation within these charter schools. But you're also looking for more accountability when it comes to the finances of these schools, things like regular audits.
Regular audits, transparency, accountability in how they spend money, taxpayer monies, what they do in terms of the reserves that are accumulated, how they actually, the relationships they have in terms of the properties they acquire and the membership on the boards and things that basically have to do with how money that is taxpayer money in this Commonwealth is spent and ensure that it's spent to do what's supposed to do.
We've been talking about brick and mortar charter schools, but there are also cyber charters in Pennsylvania. Are you working to address them and some of the potential issues that may be associated with these entities?
We're looking at both, and certainly the cyber charters are even more difficult in a sense to assess because there's less direct control from local school districts. They aren't created by the local school districts. They're created through the Department of Education. Oftentimes, they're not even near those districts, but they pull kids out of local districts and then say they're going to educate those students and then send a bill to the local district with no sense of accountability or even if these children are properly children in those districts. It's a fairly complex operation, but one that, again, needs to be made accountable and transparent.
And we just have a short time left, but what about the granting and renewal of charters themselves? Is there accountability there when it comes to that type of oversight?
There needs to be more oversight. There needs to be a greater role played by local school districts in actually assessing what the charter schools are doing and when they're not doing what they're supposed to do, making sure that they're held accountable. And I think that's a general thing, not only just for charters, but for all forms of education. If a school isn't working, something needs to be done, but particularly charters because they have a grant of a term of existence, and they also get drawn down lots of taxpayer dollars, ought to be held accountable.
And just a few seconds left, but you've put forward this report on charter schools. Where does it go from here? Do you look to legislation?
We're looking to introduce legislation to address the issues that I raised, and we're looking forward to a major effort to reform the way we do charters in Pennsylvania.
Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
We've been talking with Pennsylvania State Representative Jim Roebuck. I'm Jill Horner.